Oh, that another drop of resin left in that bucket.
Perfect measurement.
Measure by weight. Resin to mud ratio, 2.5 to 1 on this occasion. More waterproof.
So you weigh the matting dry, and then you work out how much resin you need.
Yes.
So that's going to be quite hard wearing now, is it?
Yes, it's very robust. So it's not going to fall off because it's been properly etched. Time I put these layers on it, Dave. It's going to be rock solid. Trust me, I'm a doctor. Well, the big one first. That's as well as a case.
Do you want me to hold that?
Oh, I'll put this here, I'll put the ball right. So, we have it.
So, because we etched all that, then that's...
That'll adhere to it, yeah.
Yeah.
Resin's designed to stick to itself, if you like.
Baby,
final one. And final bail here.
And what's that final bit?
That's the surface feel to give a finer finish. And rich, make it more waterproof.
Did you put catalyst in your resin?
I forgot all about it, but hopefully it'll be hard in the sunshine.
What's that roller for?
To bring the resin through the matting, make sure it's properly impregnated and removing all the air pockets. Beautiful, like a bought one.
Yeah.
Like a bought one.
Like a bought boat.
David is sanding the hull to remove all the dust and grime to key the gel coat. We can then prime it and apply the yacht kit.
So the boat's finished. We've finished painting the boat. He's dry, and as you can see, he looks quite good. As you can see, we've damaged it already getting it out. So that's another reason why we need a launch trolley.